The most interesting is screen share. Hi, and welcome to my channel. Today, we will talk about BlueKeep vulnerability, which is a critical remote code execution flaw in Windows Remote Desktop Services. I also show you a live demo of how to exploit this vulnerability using Metasploit, so you can see it in action. So let's get started. So first, what is BlueKeep? Here, as we can see, Microsoft are saying protect against BlueKeep. So it is the CVE-2019-0708, which is a critical vulnerability in remote desktop services on older Windows versions like Windows 7 and Server 2008. It allows attackers to run code without logging in just by connecting to port 3389, which is the RDP port. So BlueKeep is wormable, meaning it can spread between systems like WannaCry. So Microsoft released emergency patches in May 2019 to fix it. So if we go here, you can see you need to install this update to protect your system from the BlueKeep vulnerability. So it is Windows 7, many versions, Windows Server 2008, many versions. So before we getting into the lab, so let me show you how widespread this vulnerability is using Shodan. We can find real machines exposed with RDP and potentially vulnerable to BlueKeep. So if we go to our Shodan search engine, we can use this command here. So for example, let's test this one. So this will search the port 3389 with the OS build 606002. So let's test once here and see, we can see directly, you can see here vulnerabilities BlueKeep, and this is very dangerous. So if we go there, you can see in Shodan here it is 10, so it's very critical. So a remote code execution vulnerability exists in remote desktop services, formerly known as you can see. Let's go back once. So we have 118 machines maybe having this BlueKeep vulnerability. As you can see, BlueKeep overall. So BlueKeep, BlueKeep, many. So now I have in my environment here to test. As always, I have my Kali Linux and I have a Windows 7 machine. So this machine, let's open PowerShell once here to see what version. So I have this command, these commands here. So this command is used to see what version is this system. So we can see that this system is version 6.1.7601. So we can do the same in Shodan and search for this version. Let's back to Shodan here and search for this version instead. We will still see many machines, but not all shows that vulnerability. Here, we don't exactly know. We don't really know. You need to test. So here, so no one shows that, but I know that this version, this one, or this OS build is vulnerable. So here it is not showing, but maybe these machines here have the update to protect. So let's go back to our machine here and we can see, so this is the update that will protect you from the BlueKeep. This command shows us if the machine have that update installed. And when it will answer, so no answer, let's wait a bit here. So this command will not get back with any result, meaning that this update is not installed. So now let's shut down this and let's go into our Kali. So Kali. Okay, so we need to use Metasploit, which is a powerful open source framework used by cybersecurity professionals and hackers to find, exploit and validate vulnerabilities in systems. And so the first command we use is the msf console, which is the main command line interface for the Metasploit framework. It is where you load exploits, set payloads, and launch attacks. So let's wait until this is done here. So we need to wait until we see the Metasploit shows up here. Okay, now we are ready to send commands. So the first command in our tutorial here is this one. So this command will load the BlueKeep RDP exploit module into the Metasploit. So as we can see here, we can see CVE-2019-0708. And we click enter once. So now we are using this module, the CVE-2019-0708 BlueKeep. So the next command is to set the payload. So let's use this one here to set the payload. So, and use Meterpreter, this one. So Meterpreter is an advanced powerful payload used in Metasploit that gives you an interactive command shell on the target system. We will see when we in the victim machine, we will use Meterpreter to send commands. So reverse TCP here, as we can see, reverse TCP means the payload causes the target machine to connect back to your attacker machine over TCP. So in short, Meterpreter reverse TCP is a payload that, after exploiting a target, lets you control their machine remotely by having them connect back to you. Okay, so the next command here is this one. This is easy. So lhust and this IP address. This tells the exploit your local IP address where the target should connect back to the attacker's machine IP for the reverse shell. So in other words, lhust is my or your listening IP for incoming connections from the target. Next one is this, which is the write. So write hust, which is sets the target IP address that you want to exploit. So our host is the same as the remote host, the victim IP, where the exploit will be sent. So then we have set target to. And this typically means targeting Windows 7 SP1 or Windows Server 2008 R2, usually in 64 architecture. And now we can, for example, use this command. So this is optional now. Show targets. And this will show us the systems that we can target. So it's Windows 7 SP1 or Windows Server 2018 or 8. This version, which is I have. So next we can check. So paste and check. The check is a safe test to see if the exploit can work on the target before trying to exploit it. and it determines if the target is likely vulnerable to the exploit, and it helps avoid crashing or damaging the target system. So because this, when testing this BlueKeep, the victim maybe can keep crashing and showing the blue screen. So now we are ready and we can run this command. So only run, and we can wait here. And now, as we can see here, we have succeeded in hacking this victim machine. But what next? So now we are seeing this interpreter. What should we do? So here you can type help, and there are plenty of commands that you can, so many commands that you can use. So let's first let's take sys info, for example, and this will show us information about this victim. So for example, domain or a group, so it's not in a domain. Windows 7 build. So much information. What is interesting? So let's use the shell command, which will let us use the victim's CMD, for example. So now we are in its CMD. So let's type ipconfig all, for example. You can see all information about its network and DNS, DHCP, all information. Next command that we can, let's type host name, for example. You can see the host name. Let's type system info, for example, system info. This will generate very detailed information about that victim. Okay, now we can see that you can see here at least what updates this system has. So much info that can be used to maybe move to other victims. So now let's exit this back to Metasploit, or maybe we need that. So for example, let's look at what does the desktop. So CD users, let's take a look. Which users do we have? So the user is admin. So cd admin and dir again. So we are interested in desktop. So cd desktop and dir again. So what if you want to download this file to your machine, your Kali machine? So we can use this command here. Copy. Paste. As you can see, so we are saying download to my from the victim to my to the attacker's machine, and this is the way. So this is the file. So let's exit here and paste that again, and now you can see that you have the file here on your machine, and this is very stealthy, so users will not see, so the victim will not see any difference. And we can try to screen shot, for example. So we are saving a screenshot of the screen of this screen here. So let's open something here. And let's do a new screenshot. Let's do another thing, maybe open this one and do another screenshot. All these screenshots are saved to your machine. So if you open here, open folder, and you'll find these screenshots here, as you can see. So, very simple. And now, the most interesting is screen share. And this will see you live what is happening on the machine. So let's wait a bit here. And now you can see live what is happening. For example, let's open media, something like that, to see a difference. As you can see here, we can see it live. So this is the most maybe interesting command. So now, how to mitigate this exploit? We need to install the update. So we can go there and visit this website here. It's from Microsoft. This is the update, the keybase that we need. This one, 4499-175. We need to download that and install it on our machine. So let's download it here, maybe. Let's wait until it's done installing. So now it's done, it's open. And we need to copy that to our machine here. Let's paste that here. And we install. The other way is to enable NLA or block RDP. Let's install this. So here, if we go to control panel, this one, control panel, and system here, remote settings. Here you see allow connections from computers running. So this is the problem. You need to don't allow or allow connections only from computers running remote desktop with NLA enabled. So this is a mitigation, or install that update. So remember, this demonstration is for educational and ethical process only. Always have permission before testing or exploiting any system. So stay responsible and use your skills to improve security. So this we need to, yes. So this video is done here. So thank you for watching and see you in the next video.